Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching for today. Custom GSI ROM is a great way to use latest Android versions on your old Android devices. These are generic system images ported by developer which will boot on all Android devices running from Android 10 and above versions, which having dynamic system with unlocked bootloader. GSI loader is an innovative way to test the GSI ROM on your device. We already uploaded how to use the GSI as a dual boot on your Android device using GSI loader. You'll find its tutorial video in icard. But what if someone got fully working GSI ROM for these devices and wants to use them as a permanent ROM? So today we brought you how you can install GSI ROM on any device through this step-by-step clear video, which will solve your doubts about GSI ROM installation. Samsung users, you need to follow some extra steps which are shown at the end in the video timeline. So don't skip any part of this video. To avoid any complications, watch it carefully till the end. If you find this video helpful, then please like it and press hype button to boost our video in the YouTube rank list. Now without further delay, let's get started. We already uploaded lots of review of custom GSI ROMs. Please check video description for dedicated playlist of custom ROMs and GSI ROM reviews. Soft disclaimer is here, follow this video only if you have some basic knowledge of flashing stuffs. If something goes wrong, you are only responsible for damaging your device. So I always recommend you to first try all GSI using GSI loader. Once you think GSI ROM is fully functional for your device with less bugs, then proceed with installation as permanent ROM on your device. Here I already tested Evolution X11 Android 16 build for my Nothing Phone 1 using GSI loader, and it's nearly stable build, so let's begin. Before proceeding, please follow these steps. First, remove this GSI loader build by tapping discard button available for current GSI image on your device. Before proceeding, you need the Windows PC with all working fastboot and ADB drivers. Please take full backup of your device because this process will wipe all data of your device. You need VBMeta and VBMeta underscore system image of your currently running stock ROM. If your stock ROM did not have VBMeta underscore system image, you can skip this. Now we have to extract GSI ROM zip file on your PC, or you can also do this on Android phone using zarchive application. Gather all the files in one folder in PC, like your GSI ROM image, VBMeta and VBMeta underscore system image. Copy all of these files and paste them in the root of your C drive in PC, or you can paste them anywhere where your fastboot and ADB drivers are working in your PC. Now enable USB debugging in your device developer setting. I think you already got knowledge about basic things through our old videos. Connect your phone to PC and open CMD window within C drive where we pasted all of these files by tapping CMD in address bar and hit enter button on keyboard. In new CMD, first we have to test all of modes are working properly for your device or not. First to check ADB device mode, type ADB devices. You will get prompt on your phone, check mark and accept it. You will see your device is in the PC with its serial number got detected. Now type ADB reboot bootloader device with boot to this bootloader mode screen. This mode looks different for different devices. Now type fastboot devices in CMD, hit enter key. Your device must detect in the CMD with your device ID. Now type fastboot reboot fastboot device with boot to different mode called as fastboot D mode. For Nothing Phone 1, it looks like this and it will look different for different devices. Again type fastboot devices in CMD. CMD must recognize this mode also with your device serial ID as shown in this video. So all our required modes are detected in CMD and working. If you get issue in detection of these modes, you must need to repeat the steps of installation of ADB and fastboot drivers for your device. Now take phone in your hand. Using volume key, select reboot to bootloader in fastboot D mode. This will boot your device into normal bootloader mode. Now we have to flash two files that we pasted in a C drive. type command fastboot flash space dash dash disable dash verification space flash vmeta and drag vmeta file in cmd and hit enter key. After flashing of vmeta get successful, type another command fastboot space dash dash disable dash verification space flash vmeta underscore system and drag vmeta underscore system file in cmd. If your stock firmware did not have vmeta underscore system file, then you can only flash vmeta file. Skip this step. Now again type fastboot reboot fastboot. This will boot back your device in a fastboot D mode. Now type another command fastboot erase system. Once done, now type fastboot flash system and drag GSI image file which you want to flash and hit enter key. If your flashing starts in the CMD, then you don't have to follow next steps that I am going to show you here. Here I got some errors, so you have to type next command. Type fastboot space delete dash logical dash partition space system underscore ext and hit enter key. Next type same command, just change the system name as a system underscore ext underscore a. Once done, again type same command, just change system underscore ext underscore b. Once this command's flashing gets successful, type fastboot space delete dash logical dash partition space product and hit enter key. Similarly, type same command, just replace product as product underscore a and product underscore b. So our flashing of all commands is done. Now type fastboot space flash space system and drag your GSI image file in a CMD and hit enter key. This time your flashing will start within 1 or 2 minutes. This process will take 5 to 10 minutes, so wait patiently, don't disturb your device, keep it connected. Once flashing of system image gate finishes, take your phone in hand, remove phone cable from PC, using volume up down keys, select reboot to recovery and press power button. This will immediately boot your device in a recovery mode. Recovery mode of your device may look different for different devices. Now using volume keys, select factory reset, select format data and press power button to confirm. Once formatting gets done, reboot your device to system. Your device will definitely boot to your desired GSI setup screen. Here my Nothing Phone 1 booted to Evolution X Android 16 setup screen. So this is our brand new phone running with Android 16, which is a dream for everyone, and we made it possible. Now you got your desired ROM as a primary ROM for your device, which have total device storage available for your GSI build only. GSI ROM boots with the DSU loader only gets the user data size which you allocated during installation. If you restart your device, it will boot to your generic ROM only. Hope you got clear idea how to install your stable GSI ROM via fastboot. This process will work for all devices which successfully booted their DSU image via DSU loader. But for Samsung devices, some steps are different which you must note down. Written steps for these changes are given in a written format in video description. Soon I will release another video to flash GSI build through custom recoveries like TWRP, Orange Fox, etc. In that tutorial, you don't have to follow these lengthy CMD commands. So wait for that video. This step shown in video will work for any device except Samsung devices to flash their desired GSI ROM via fastboot. But I can't guarantee it will work for all devices. This is all over for today. If you found this video helpful, then please do like and share this video. Press new hype button to rank our video in YouTube rank list. Press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming GSI ROM reviews and more content for all Android devices. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.